speaks loudest. Some creatures that reside in the silence. In too many dark places. In too many hearts. Too many secrets under the surface. Too many closets filled with bones.
Hi guys, I'm Steve from Death Rattle. Thanks for joining me, opening the show with a song by a Portuguese band, Oak, probably here in the background. The song's called Sculptures. It's off the new Lone album out through Transcending Obscurity. It's quite a lengthy track and it's some excellent atmospheric doom death, which is a genre that's having something of a renaissance at the moment. Enjoy. was Portuguese band Oak with the song Sculptures from the Lone album. This has come out through Transcending Obscurity label, and by no means the longest track on the album either. As I say, it's part of a renaissance of the atmospheric funeral doom that's coming out, been produced over the last 18 months. I used to be into funeral doom quite heavily years ago. That was pretty much all I listened to, and I kind of got bored with it after a while, but certainly these new bands are bringing me back into the fraternity again. So the show's going to be probably the most indulgent one I've produced for quite some time. A lot of extremity with it, some highly underground bands, not more so than the band I'm going to play a song from now. The band's called Nocturnal Convocation, and I'm playing a song, Capitulum 2, off the Mors Omnia Solvit album that's just come out through Curse Monk Records. And for research purposes, guys, I did check on Google to see what Mors Omnia Solvit means in Latin, and it's something to do with death dissolves all things, which is pretty apt for this band. I say highly occult, and I hope you enjoy it. So this is Capitulum 2. We'll be right back. eyes. God knows what we've invoked playing that song. Look behind you. That was Nocturnal Convocation with Capitulum 2. And I say very mysterious band. No photos, no information, no lyrics. Which is probably just as well. But speaking of invoking nasty things, next band up is Demoniac. And playing The Beginning of Chaos off the new Dwellers of Apocalypse album. Talk about excellent entombed worship. This is it now. play another new song for you now by a band called Dead Woman's Ditch. They have a new album out called, I find it very difficult to pronounce to be honest, because it's one of those with the A in the E linked together. It's H-R-A-E-F-N. So sorry guys, can't pronounce it seeing as I'm not very good with the Queen's Own English myself. So the album's great. Band plays a particularly gnarly brand of blackish doom. Certainly on the Seo Mir Satan album, which is the predecessor to this one. The new album is takes an even further leap into the black stuff, so it took me a little bit of getting used to, I must admit, but after a few listens, the doom parts are kind of lurking there, and it's a really excellent album. It's on the Roberto Mora's Third Eye Rex label. Played a few of Roberto's bands on the show in the past, although not for quite a while, to be honest, for some reason. So anyway, I'll give you Inside the Void by Dead Woman's Ditch.
We'll be right back.
play some more new Doom for you. This is In My Blood by Black Tundra. It's off the new Daylight Dies album that's just come out. We'll be right back. I'm going to give you another dose of death metal now. This is a band called Apocryphal. They're from the mecca of old school death metal, Finland. This is their first release and it's a pretty excellent one. The release is called Crushing Black Death, and I'll play the title track for you now. This is Apocryphal. Played some pretty heinous stuff for you today. I'm going to take a little tiny step back for you and play a new song off a brand new band. The band's called Ike's Wasted World, and it features Ike Joseph, who was part of a pretty classic heavy metal band called Lost Breed, which featured Wino Weinrich in the past. As I say, it's a new song, and it's a great pleasure to play it for you and introduce the band to you. The song's called Speed Queen, and I'll give you Ike's Wasted World.
Looking for a sign. It's like a blind leading the blind that's right in front of me. But you believe what you wanna believe. I don't feel no pain at all. It's like the rise right before the fall. I'll make them dance like marionettes. In the end, I guess you get what you get. You pay your money and you take your chance. Bet it all on the wheel of romance. Around and round and around the scene. Under the neon lights, I'm riding with the Speed Queen.
forward to hearing a bit more of that band. That was Ike's Wasted World with a track called Speed Queen. So as soon as I know if anything else is due out, then I'll obviously be playing it, and I'll be posting it on the blog as well. So I have played in the last couple of weeks a track by a band called Mendoza. It's a new track from a release that's coming out in January, and I didn't realise until Brian Montgomery told me of Broken Net Radio that Bina Mendoza also was part of another band that I'm into. The band's called Heron. So I thought I'd play a song from that band for you tonight. And the song I'm going to play is off the Low Winter's Sun album, and it's called Of Gods and Goats.
We'll be right back.
Funeral Sludge. We're going to hear some now. This is Italian band, another Italian band called Vij, V-I-J. The debut album of theirs, self-titled one, which came out in 2015, I think it was. It was 2014-2015, one of the two. It was the first album, or one of the very first albums I reviewed when I set up the Shrieks from Below blog. It's totally nasty, as only the likes of Begrabness or Hypoxia or Corrupted can create. This track's quite long and it's extremely heavy, but I wanted to play it for you today. See what you think.
Thank you. Yeah.
was Italian band Vidge with a track called, well, part of the track's called Crocodile, the other one I can't quite pronounce. It was available on Bandcamp, but it doesn't appear to be now. There's another album on there. That's one of my favourite ones, though, and I've played it quite often over the last few years. So I'm going to end the show with one more song, and it's yet another brand new one. With another brand new band. I'm going to read the bio out to you because it's quite interesting. And it says, oozing from the sweltering, snake-infested sugarcane fields of eastern South Africa, the Slunge duo, Son of Seeds, have unleashed two unique and bludgeoning songs for their debut self-titled EP, set for release on the 24th of Jan 2020. There are elements of doom, old school, southern sludge, accidental Sabbathian grooves and Melvins-esque sinister tones present in this grimy glob of a track. So there you go. It's a song called Arterial Mule, and it's by South African band Son of Seeds. New EP is due out in January. Well, new EP, very first release of theirs. The song's as described. It's a mixture of all kinds, and they've invented a new genre, slunge. I hope you enjoy it. And thanks very, very, very much for listening and staying with me. And I hope you may have discovered your new favourite band. I'm going to leave you now with Son of Seeds with Arterial Mule.